Hello students, we will be talking about pasteurization today. As we all know, or as we all have understood, that it was this process was explained by Louis Pasteur, which is true, but it was Louis Pasteur who explained the pasteurization for wine. But the pasteurization of milk can be done, or the process of pasteurization can be employed for milk also. That was explained by Dr. Soxhlet in the year 1886, and thus the name pasteurization has come. Now, what is this? If we have to define it, it is the process of heating every particle of milk that is there to 63 degrees centigrade and maintaining it for 30 minutes, or and then cooling it for 5 degrees centigrade or below. Or heating every particle of milk to 72 degrees centigrade and maintaining for 15 seconds and then cooled for 5 degrees centigrade. So this is called as pasteurization. Now, what is the purpose of pasteurization? Now, why do we need to pasteurize the milk? So that it is safe for human consumption, so that it is made sure that there are no pathogenic microorganisms. It is made sure that all the microorganisms, all the disease causing microorganisms are killed, and hence it can be consumed for by the human beings. Basically, it is safe for human consumption. Second, as we all know that milk is a complete food. It is rich in various nutrients. It is high in moisture content and also sugar. Hence, it is easy access for the microorganisms to grow in the milk. And hence, milk can be spoiled easily. The shelf life of milk is very small because of the reasons that I have quoted. We need to pasteurize milk so that we get rid of all these microorganisms, the organisms that will result in the spoilage of milk, and also it will help in the keeping quality, or it will help in improvise in increasing the shelf life of milk by destroying the organisms that will spoil the milk. Moving on to the standards of pasteurization. If we have to say that milk has been completely pasteurized, there are certain standards that has been put. What are those standards? It is made sure that there is complete destruction of these two organisms, that is Mycobacterium tuberculosis and Coxiella burnetii. Now, these two are the indicator organisms for pasteurization. These two are the most resistant organisms that is found on the earth. And if these organisms are being killed in the milk, have been destroyed in the milk, then we can be sure that definitely other organisms are also killed, and hence the pasteurization has happened properly. That is one standard that is done to check whether pasteurization has been done completely and properly. Next is to check for the presence of phosphatase enzyme. Phosphatase is an enzyme that is present in raw milk, but as the milk is heated, the enzyme gets deactivated, it gets disintegrated. So if the phosphatase enzyme is absent in the milk, that means we can be sure that yes, the milk has been properly pasteurized according to the given standards, the temperature and the time. So we check for the negative phosphatase enzyme, phosphatase test. And when we are doing the different temperatures and the time pasteurization is done, it has to be made sure that there is least damage to the cream layer of the milk, and also the flavor is not altered. Moving on to the types of pasteurizations, there are different types of pasteurizations: LTLT, HTST and UHT. LTLT is low temperature, long time, that is you are keeping the milk for low temperature, less temperature, and which is the holding time is long, that is why it is called as LTLT. Here the temperature is 63 degrees centigrade, which is maintained for 30 minutes. And these are of two types, that is in-bottle pasteurization and batch or holding pasteurization. This is the pasteurization that we generally do in our houses also. Next is the high temperature short time pasteurization, HTST, wherein the milk is heated to around 72 degrees centigrade, which is maintained for 15 seconds. Students, please note, it is not 15 minutes, it is 15 seconds. The next kind of pasteurization is the UHT, that is ultra high temperature pasteurization. pasteurization. Here the temperature is 135 degree centigrade, and the time duration you can see here, it's just 3 seconds, 1 to 3 seconds it is. So within 3 seconds the pasteurization is over. Here this is also called as uperization or ultra pasteurization. All these methods have their own advantages and disadvantages. Let us look into the details of these. Next, now when we do the pasteurization, there are various factors that depend on what type of pasteurization that has to be selected. There are various factors like if I have to pasteurize a milk sample, now which temperature should I follow, which technique should I follow. There are various factors that play into role. Now what are those various factors which will tell us as to what kind of pasteurization we have to decide? First of all, volume of the milk sample. If the volume is huge, huge amount of milk has to be pasteurized, and definitely I have to go for the high temperature pasteurization because the time taken is less there. And if the volume is less, then definitely if it's just half a liter of milk, then 1 liter of milk, then definitely we have to go for the low temperature long time pasteurization. That is what we follow even in our houses. Next, access to the sophisticated equipment. Now if we have to go for the high temperature pasteurization, or if you have to go for ultra high temperature pasteurization, next we should see whether do we have those equipments to follow that procedure. If those equipments are not there, then definitely we have to go for low temperature, because low temperature long time pasteurization do not require sophisticated. So depending on the equipments that is available, kind of pasteurization is selected. Next, target microbes. What kind of microbes are there? Is it already pasteurized, and am I going to heat it once again? That is, at home milk is brought in packets, which is a pasteurized milk, and then we heat it again. So those kind of pasteurizations, I know that pathogens are killed, it's only to increase the shelf life. In that case, low temperature long time pasteurization is sufficient. But if I do not know what kind of organisms, how many organisms, if pathogens are there, if I have to kill the pathogens, then definitely I have to go for the higher temperature to kill the microorganisms. So the kind of pasteurization, the type of pasteurization will vary. Next, purpose of pasteurization. Now why do I need to pasteurize? Do I need to keep the milk sample for a long duration? Do I need to go keep it for 3 months? Do I need to keep it for just 1 month? Do I need to keep the milk just for a day? Then it depends. If it is just for a day, long temperature, low temperature pasteurization is sufficient. But if I have to keep it for 3 months, 4 months, then I have to use ultra high temperature pasteurization. So it depends on the volume of milk, the sophisticated equipments that I have, the microorganisms that I need to kill, and what is the purpose that I'm pasteurizing for. So these are the reasons that based on these I decide on to what kind of pasteurization I will follow. These are the different temperatures that I had just now told. Now moving on to the low temperature long time pasteurization. Now what do we do here is we are going to heat the milk, that is for 63 degree centigrade, and which is maintained for 30 minutes. Now when we do this, most of the pathogens are killed, and also the load of microorganisms are reduced. I will not tell it will become zero, but then the load becomes less, and hence because the temperature is low here, it does not interfere in the flavor of the milk. The cream layer of the milk is not lost, and also the load of microorganisms are lessened here. Because the load is less, the chemical properties, the physical and the chemical properties of milk are also not lost. Moving on to the types of LTLT. Now, as I had told you, there is two types of LTLT pasteurization, that is in bottle pasteurization, and there is batch pasteurization. Now in bottle, from the name itself, it says milk is filled in the bottles and then pasteurization happens. Okay, batch pasteurization, the milk is not filled in bottles. First pasteurization happens and then packaging happens. So here what happens is it is a double walled stainless steel container. The bottles are filled with raw milk, and these bottles are placed inside the inner jacket, and then there is an outer jacket. Now there is a space between the inner and the outer jacket. Now what happens here is there is water that is filled between the inner and the outer jacket. Now this what, and then this is closed. This is maintained at 63 degree centigrade, kept for half an hour, and then it is cooled. Thus the pasteurization happens. Now after already the packaging has happened, packaging of milk has happened, and hence directly it is sent for cooling and then it is sent for dispatching. What are the advantages and disadvantages? Now because the after pasteurization makes sure that microorganisms are killed. Now after pasteurization there are chances that during packeting it can lead to contamination, but since before itself the packeting is over, here packaging is over and then pasteurization happens, and hence post pasteurization contamination is not there here. That is what it means. What are the disadvantages? Because you will be using glass bottles here, definitely the heat that is applied or that is generated should be gradually increased. Sudden increase of heat may result in breakage or damage to the glass bottles. The glass bottles may break by when rubbing against each other, all while mass handling of the glass bottles. Second, you know that when you heat the milk will expand, and hence double sized or oversized glass bottles has to be used. Definitely the bottles are closed and then they are pasteurized, so when during this the milk will expand, it should not flow out or it should not burst out, and hence only half of the bottle has to be filled with the milk. The rest of the half should be left for head space for the milk to expand. So these are the disadvantages. So we have to use really large bottles, oversized bottles for the packaging. Otherwise oversized bottles may not be required if the packaging happens later on. Moving on to the batch or holding pasteurization, there are three types, that is water jacket vat, the water spray type and the coil vat type. Now what happens here is the milk is not packeted and then pasteurized. First it is pasteurized and then it is going for packeting. So what is there here? This is the jacket wherein the pasteurization happens. It is made up of a double walled jacket. There is an inner wall and there is an outer wall. There is jacket space in between the inner and the outer wall. There is a sparger or there is a shaft. Why are all these things? Let us see. Inside the inner jacket, the milk sample that has to be pasteurized is placed. In between, the outer jacket is for the protection and is insulated and does not allow the heat to move out. In between the inner wall and the outer jacket, there is a space. Now here, if it is a water jacket vat type, what happens is the water is filled here in between this space and the water is maintained at 63 degree centigrade, kept for half an hour. If it is a water spray type, from the outer jacket which is facing inwards, there are sprayers. Water is sprayed towards the inner jacket this way. Water is sprayed towards the inner jacket and water is not stagnated there. Continuously water is sprayed. Water which is maintained at 63 degree centigrade, which is sprayed towards the inner jacket, and thus there is circulation of the water, does not allow the water to stagnate there, and hence the pasteurization happens, which is maintained for half an hour. Coil vat type means there is no water involved here. There are coils that is fixed in between the inner and the outer jacket. These coils are in turn connected to the electricity, and when you connect to the electricity, definitely the coils gets heated up, the temperature is increased, which is maintained for 63 degree centigrade, kept for half an hour, and then it is cooled. So the coils are kept if it is a coil vat type of pasteurization. Now here remember, the milk is first pasteurized, and once the pasteurization is over, the milk is cooled to 5 degree and later on it is sent for packaging. So post pasteurization contamination may happen here. Next, as I had told you, it has its own advantages and disadvantages of LTLT. Advantages of LTLT is that there is no alteration in the flavor of the milk. There is no the cream layer is not altered there of the milk, because it's not high temperature. That's the advantage. What are the disadvantages? It takes a very long duration of time. it can be the milk by this method can be maximum stored for 1 or 2 days, not more than that. Other disadvantages is that all, it's not that this does not kill all the organisms, but most of the load is reduced here. Moving on to HTST. HTST is high temperature short time. Here, as we had seen, that milk is stored heated for 72 degrees centigrade, which is maintained for 15 seconds, and then it is cooled immediately for 5 degrees. Now here, students, you have to tell about the cooling of milk for 5 degrees centigrade. Pasteurization, you just mentioned about milk being heated to 72 degrees, which is maintained for 15 seconds. You do not mention cooling of the milk. That also is a part of pasteurization. Now this HTST is a kind of flash pasteurization, and this method you can store the milk for around 15 to 21 days, almost a month you can store the milk. What are the advantages? The advantages are that it requires less time and the initial cost is less. Now why initial cost is less? Because I do not require many instruments, just one instrument within half an hour, because it requires only 15 seconds. Within half an hour, I can pasteurize many loads of milk samples. Less floor space. Again, I do not require many instruments, just one instrument, and the time, because the time duration is less, in that given time duration I can pasteurize many loads of milk. Short time is required. Disadvantage is, because the temperature is high, there are chances that milk stone can be formed. I told you milk stone is, if the milk dries, it forms into the dried form of milk basically. So there are chances that milk stone can be formed, and definitely the flavor is lost. Next, the vacuum pasteurization or vacidation. Now here what happens is that there is a system injection system, steam injection system. Now what happens here is, in the steam injection system, of course it is sterilized. First the milk is passed through the steam injection system, and then the steam is passed. Now this is kept for half an hour, which is maintained at 63 degree centigrade. Okay, now because the milk is coming in contact with the steam, now this happens in vacuum, there is no air here. So because the sterilization happens in not temperature but then with steam, the off flavors are all sucked on by the steam, and then finally sterile milk is removed out of the steam injection system. Now what are the advantages of this? Advantages is, it removes the off volatile off flavors. You know that one kind of flavor it has, off flavor, kind of smell it has. So these kind of things are removed during vacuum pasteurization or vacidation. Moving on to the next one, that is UHT, that is ultra high temperature pasteurization. This was recently developed, that is in the year 1950, and as we know, the temperature is around 135 to 150 degrees centigrade, which is maintained at 1 to 3 seconds. It's just 1 second or maximum 3 seconds. Okay, now here immediately the milk is aseptically packaged, and here you can keep the milk for around 3 to 4 months. The time duration that you can store the milk is large. In other words, the keeping quality of milk is long. What are the advantages and disadvantages? It requires less processing time. Within half an hour, you can pasteurize loads and loads of milk sample, and the shelf life is more. What are the disadvantages? Definitely, because you're increasing the temperature, there are chances that some of the nutrients could get disintegrated into the milk. You know that milk is rich in proteins too, so the proteins gets easily disintegrated with high temperature. Not only proteins, there are other nutrients also that could get disintegrated or that can get affected because of the high temperature. Second, it will lose its original flavor. The cream layer also gets affected because of the very high temperature. So these are the disadvantages. Next one is your upertization or ultra pasteurization. Now this initially was developed in Switzerland. Now this is a step by process. Initially the flavor, off flavor, is removed, and then pasteurization is done here. It's direct, it is with steam, like your upertization, like your the steam sterilization that we had seen, the same kind of process happens here in uparization, wherein first the milk is heated to around 50 degrees centigrade. Now when you do this, the off flavor that is dissolved and the dissolved oxygen, all volatile off flavors are lost. It is removed, of course, by vacuum treatment. After this off flavors are removed, what happens is that the milk is heated to around 80 to 90 degrees centigrade, and then slowly it is increased with pressure in steam, which is maintained at 50 degrees centigrade. This 50 degrees centigrade is steam is applied at 50 degrees centigrade, and which is maintained to just half a second or 3/4 of a second. Now 80 to 90 degrees centigrade is not steam, it is heated. After that, it is steam is applied at 150 degrees centigrade, which is just maintained to half a minute or 3/4 of a second. It's not even a minute, it is 3/4 of a second. So this off flavors are lost, and also you can store the milk for a long duration of time. It is still not applied in India in many places. What are the advantages? Definitely because off flavors are also lost, and organisms are killed because of a very high temperature. The long keeping quality, it can be stored for a long duration of time. All the organisms, the pathogens, and most of the organisms are killed here. Here the volatile off flavors, unwanted flavors, the kind of smell, odor that is there is lost. This is completely homogenized. There is no loss, or there is no, it does not affect the cream layer. Now because why? Because it is continuously happening in steam, so there is no separation of cream that is happening. And also there is reduction in acidity. Because there are no organisms, definitely the acidity does not increase in nature. Also the nutrients are all there. They are not lost, because the time that you're giving for the very high temperature is slowly gradually increasing in temperature. It's not a sudden increase in temperature. And also it happens in steam, and the time is just half a second, so the nutrients are not lost there. So these are the advantages of using uparization or ultra pasteurization. So these are the different types of pasteurization, the process of pasteurization, advantages and disadvantages, also the standards of pasteurization. If the question on pasteurization is asked, you have to exactly mention slide by slide how we have studied, who coined the term, who explained about it, the definition, also the standards of pasteurization, the different types of pasteurization, and explain the different types. So with the advantages and disadvantages. Thank you, students.